Welcome to Explore the Ancients.
Welcome back, friends and fellow explorers. Unfortunately, I wasn't able to get out to a site this week, but I did get down to the Big Darby, do a quick hike to the Fort Ancient Mound and back. So hopefully, you'll join me on this little adventure. How nice is this? Looks like some very fortunate students get to study down here by the creek. The way to the mound is to the left, but this trail to the right is usually closed, so I definitely want to go down here to the shore and take a look around. I wanted to line up the shore with the mound, because I had a hunch there would be a nice landing area for people to come ashore. I think I see down there the spot we come to from the other side. This whole side of the creek so far has been nice and flat. Okay, it looks like we made it. Across there is Wagtail Trail, and that's where we usually come from. And back there is the big tree that I talked about on a previous video that I think is a cache tree. And up the hill here on the left, directly up the hill, is the mound. Just up there, I think we can see our landing area. It's nice and flat. Comes out far into the creek there, and just up there up the hill is the mound. I've been seeing some pits around. I'm not sure what that could be. Hey, want to try one of these horse apples or whatever you call them? And as you can see on the map here, we are the blue dot and the mound is the yellow dot there, so we are lined up. And I have to say, this looks like a perfect landing area. Okay, we're back on the trail going back the other way, and up there on the top of the hill there is the mound. So let's just follow the trail and have a look before we head back. This is the most northern Fort Ancient site known. There was a huge circular village here, with the mound just on the edge of it. This was approximately 900 years ago, but I'm sure people have inhabited this place many times over the years. Well, it's time to head back. Thanks for exploring with me. Hope to see you on the next one.